And welcome everybody. Today we're going to be working on a monogram 1 to 24 scale Terry Labonte number 5 Lumina Kellogg's Corn Flakes. This is a NASCAR, so let's start by unbagging it and carrying on with the project. And as you can see, it's all molded in yellow. The instructions call for all the colors but yellow, so it's not meant to be painted, but I'm not going to do that when we paint it. So here I'm just using to me a thin cement to glue all the pieces together that we're going to paint together. And that's usually what I do with my model. So here I'm going to glue them together. Once it's all together, I'm going to start spraying it. And I just use a Vallejo aluminum model air right out of the container. Mix your paint well, make sure all your parts are clean. The exhaust I did Vallejo model air steel. I used Vallejo Surface Primer 73601 gray, and that's what I used to prime, and I left the cage and everything, the chassis, this color. I usually use this color or 73615 USM Light Ghost Gray Surface Primer from Vallejo. That one's a little darker, and that's the one I usually use, but it's one of the two. This one is the lighter one, it's just gray. Next, I went into gluing on the body and giving everything else a chance to dry. And while it was drying, I went to gluing on the front bumper and the rear bumper. I used CA and accelerator to help in the process, make sure everything was lined up. This body actually went through quite a bit, so the whole process isn't in here, and to make up for it, I did have to replace the decals, so I used a slick set, and I did a majority of the slick set throughout this video, so you can see that later on. And now you can see the body is just in the primer, and then I did a couple of acrylics on it, yellow, red. The decals didn't turn out, like I said, and I did a good job, and see that coming up here soon. So here's the model. I tried to scrape the roof and the hood off, and it didn't come off, so I'm going to use Easy Off here. I made another video on how to do this process, and it works with enamels, acrylics, slackers. So if you're interested in removing paint, you can watch that video. And this video, you can see I just quickly soaked what I did at the beginning. And for a more thorough understanding of it, just watch the other video. So you'll see I then continued on by priming the model again once it was clean, and just using rattle cans to get my color done. So I don't know why I used Krylon here, but it actually turned out in the end. You should never mix brands of paints. I highly don't recommend you do that. I usually like Rust-Oleum. That's my favorite brand for doing this kind of stuff. And yeah, the front half is Krylon, the back half, the red is Rust-Oleum. So again, don't do that. It's pretty silly. You need to mix the two brands. Always try to stick with the same brand. And that works with glues and primers too. I mean, primers generally work for all brands, but clearing, try to keep all your chemicals with the same brand. So here I want to show you the stock decals and the slicks decals that we're going to use. The stock decals wrinkled up, the hood decal yellowed and bubbled. So these are the stock decals. I'm not too happy with them. I'm going to have two or three more sets. The slicks decals, although they are way tougher to put on. As you see those side decals there with just one piece on the slicks decals, you got to put every stripe on. And I coated these. I'm going to show you guys how I coated them. So the fives here, I'm trying to show that they're not the same color. The five from the stock decal set is what I matched my yellow to. When the new slicks decals came, they were a different color. Oh well. This here is microscale liquid decal film, and I used this to hopefully restore my decals that I got, because I didn't want them to crack or bubble again. And unfortunately with decals, you don't know until they hit water what their reaction is going to be. So to prevent any more fails, I applied some of this liquid over each of the decals, which you'll see me do here. And I waited about 15 minutes and added another coat. And what I guess this does is helps reinforce the decal. A couple did still break, but for the majority they did hold together. But again, I don't know if they're broken or not. This is just a preventive maintenance procedure, I guess we could call it. Now, the original decals have a red striped bottom front grill decal here, but what I did is I just quickly masked off the bottom half and hand painted it red, and then applied that striped decal, or decal, as some people pronounce it. Next, I masked the windows and I didn't thoroughly go over that in this video. I'm going to do a video separately just on painting windows. So here you'll see just quickly how I did it. All right, everyone. Well, this is how it looks all finished up. The underside is pretty plain, and if you guys like how I did my wheels, I'm gonna do another video just on how to detail wheels, because that's a whole other process on its own. But there's the engine bay with some anodized components, and I did put the Simpson deco decal too low on the netting. But otherwise, I was pretty happy how it turned out. I just tried to keep it plain and simple. And, yeah, so if you guys liked it, and I think it turned out alright. But if you guys liked it, write a comment down below. If you didn't like it, you can also write a comment. And if you guys have any suggestions on future builds, let me know what you think. Yeah, so thanks for watching. Hopefully you learned what to do and what not to do. And like and subscribe, guys and girls. Have a good one. And do some finished pictures of it. So hope you enjoyed. Thanks again.